In NASCAR's Deflategate, the sport cracking down on one of its top drivers, Ryan Newman, and his team accused of cheating by letting the air out of the tires. They now face a tough penalty, and ABC's Ryan Smith is here with all the details. Good morning to you, Ryan.
Good morning to you, Lara. It's an issue some say threatened to dog NASCAR this season. Drivers allegedly manipulating tires to gain a competitive advantage in a sport where your wheels are crucial. Now one driver's team has been caught, and NASCAR is hanging them out to dry.
Ryan Newman is going to get in with that move.
This morning, NASCAR flagging one of its top racing teams for cheating. The Racing Association Tuesday docking driver Ryan Rocketman Newman 75 crucial Sprint Cup points, fining his crew chief $125,000 and suspending three members of his crew for deflating his tires during this race last month, where he finished fifth. The penalty dropping Newman from 6th to 26th in the race for NASCAR's biggest prize, the Sprint Cup. Overnight, Newman's team telling ABC News, "We understand the seriousness of the penalty," adding they've been outspoken against tire bleeding and vowing to conduct an internal investigation. All season, NASCAR has been concerned about tire bleeding, poking minuscule holes in tires to slowly release air, improving tire durability, and helping drivers achieve that ideal grip on the track. It's a concern that superstar Jeff Gordon raised on Friday.
I've heard about a lot of things, you know, with valve caps and poking holes in tires for years.
NASCAR seized tires from 8 of its track leaders during a 2-week period this month. At the time, NASCAR officials told ABC News tire inspections are frequent and not unusual. Now those racers' tires have come back clean, except for Newman's. NASCAR telling ABC News overnight, "We've been very clear that any modifications to race vehicle tires is an unacceptable practice and will not be tolerated."
Newman's team hasn't yet decided whether they will appeal, but NASCAR's decision seems incredibly quick in comparison to another sport facing deflation issues. The NFL is still investigating those allegations of deflated football.
It's taking so long.
Oh, they're working on a report.
Thanks very much.